can't believe how much biodiversity there is in this forest.
I bet I saw the fish in the bromeliad.
And those sloths and those monkeys.
And look at all of these plants, you guys. The diversity is crazy.
Hey, check this out. I just got a Snapchat from Michelle.
Oh.
Wow.
That plant is moving.
Oh my god.
You guys, I think that's it right there.
Is that it?
Weird.
Oh my god.
Is it helping it?
How does that make it an animal?
Fast as it
Maybe
go.
It keeps animals from eating
Can
it?
Can it do it in the rain? Can it do it when it's dry?
What happens to it at night?
Yeah, does light affect it?
You guys, we've got too many questions. We need to go and think about this.
Good point.
Hey, did you guys get my snap? That was awesome.
It's the most amazing thing I've seen.
We have so many questions.
Once it's closed, how long does it take for it to open again?
Does it close at the same speed in the wind and the rain?
How does a closing of leaves defend itself against predators?
Do the age of the leaves make any difference in how fast it closes?
I wonder if it's a chemical or mechanical stimulus that makes it close.
All right, guys, so we've been through a lot of different questions, and we've decided on this one as the one we want to test. How does the time for the leaflet to reopen change after repeated triggered closings? So we're going to close the leaf, we're going to time how long it takes to open, then we'll do it again and see if there's any difference. We think maybe it'll take more time, maybe it'll take less time, maybe it won't make a difference at all. Now we need to standardize our methods and get in the field.
We began by identifying an appropriate mimosa plant. All of our plants had leaves that measured between 4 and 6 centimeters in length from base to tip and were free from herbivory. We photographed the leaf in its original position, so we would know when it returned to its fully open state. We triggered the plant by running our finger along the leaf from stem to tip and started the timer once the leaflets had closed. We waited until the leaflets reopened and compared the new position to the original photograph. Once we decided the leaflets had reopened, we stopped the timer and recorded the time. We then waited 1 minute before triggering the plant again.
After what seemed like 1,000 years, we traveled back to crunch the numbers. The data from every member of the group was combined into one data table. We had 10 plants total. We noticed that each individual plant was different than the others. For example, one plant that Ivy looked at was slow every time it reopened, and one plant that Keisha looked at was fast every time it reopened. To reduce the differences we saw, we decided to calculate a ratio. We divided each reopening time by the first reopening time for that plant, get the average ratio of reopening time. That way, we were comparing patterns in the time it took for the leaflets to reopen between plants, kind of like a handicap in golf or other sports. Next, we found the average of those ratios. We also calculated standard error, which is just one way of measuring how much variation there is in the data.
In order to clearly communicate the patterns we saw, we made a graph. On the x-axis, we put the number of triggered closings. On the y-axis, we put the average ratio of reopening time. The first bar shows the average ratio of time to reopen the first time we touch the plants to close the leaflets. The second bar shows the average ratio of time to reopen the second time we close the plant, and so on. The higher the bar, the longer the plant took to reopen its leaflets. We also put the error bars.
Our data shows that mimosa plants reopen their leaves more quickly the first time they are closed. After that, mimosa plants reopen the leaves more slowly. The variation we see in the time to reopen after the first triggered reopening was not significant. This data supports our hypothesis that the leaflet would take more time to reopen after repeated triggered closings. Obviously, more data will help support our conclusions.
Now we know that mimosa leaves reopen more slowly after the first triggered closing.
But all science leads to more questions.
Yeah, like what molecular mechanism causes the leaflet to open more slowly?
We still don't know why mimosa leaves evolved the ability to reopen in the first place.
And so, back to the lab. Let's close this. You can't touch this. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this.